ค่ะ Welcome to Thailand Today here on NBT World. As Thailand has become an aging society, this translates to changes or challenges with care and support of senior people. Falls and fractures are common genetic problems. Diabetes and related mobility disability will increase in prevalence as the population ages and become more overweight. So today, Professor Dr. Arirat Suputhithada, the Department of Rehabilitation Medicine, Faculty of Medicine, Chulalongkorn University, she will tell us about advancement and spinal stenosis treatments in the field of physical and rehabilitation medicine to deal with these population changes. So, สวัสดีค่ะ ดร. ค่ะ
สวัสดีค่ะ
Well, welcome to Thailand Today program after a long time.
Okay.
Well, today is again very interesting because our country going to move on into the aging society. But before that, we need to hear about your mission, the mission and services from the department of this. What, how it is like of the rehabilitation medical?
Okay. In our department, we follow the mission of the Faculty of Medicine, Chulalongkorn University, that we have like the mission of Med is CU Plus.
Oh,
yes, for the abbreviation. M mean morality.
Morality.
Yes. And E mean excellence.
Excellence. Yes. Yes.
And D mean dignity.
Dignity.
I mean innovation.
Innovation.
Okay. Yeah. And S mean social responsibility. And C mean continued improvement.
Wow.
Okay. And U mean unity and plus. Okay. So our mission is producing the undergraduate, mean that medical student to complete medical degree and medical specialist to learn in rehabilitation. Yeah, so we produce a medical specialist as that is the main duty as well. Yes, to serve the whole country in rehabilitation medicine. And beyond that, we also do a lot of research, innovation to prove the advancements of rehabilitation. Okay, because you need to have the advance for quality of life for the patient. Okay.
Interesting, interesting. Well, so you are as a physical professor of physical and rehabilitation medicine, so you are being appointed in many positions of internationally and and domestically. So we need to hear about your achievements. What are the maybe long listed of your awards and all that?
Yeah. You got
certain important
thank you. I'm the youngest professor in rehabilitation. Let's say that the youngest professor in Thailand because after I complete my medical degree and then I training in rehabilitation and after that I going abroad to US to further study in neuro rehabilitation and pain rehabilitation as well. Yes, after that when I come back to the university, Chulalongkorn University, I love to do research. Okay, so I do the research and publish a lot of research in advancement. Let's say that botulinum toxin, low dose botulinum toxin, and pain as well. Yes, and pain intervention, many pain intervention. Okay, and also the gait and motion in patient who have a disability, and also the biomechanic and movement disability as well. Okay.
You must be a very brilliant student.
Yeah, and and also I have a chance. I have been invited to be the committee in International Physical Medicine and Rehabilitation. So in our society, since we are quite new in the medical field, but we have the mission of rehabilitation. We would like to improve the quality of life for the patient. Mm. So we have a lot of knowledge that we need to brainstorm together. Mm. Okay, brainstorm together and to create the the all of the advancement in rehabilitation, and we need to categorize that which treatment is suitable for the underdeveloping country, which one suitable for the
developing
country, and which one is for the developed country already. Yeah. Okay, and maybe in the future, every country can have all of this advancement in rehabilitation.
I think so. Yeah.
We have the mission
with that. We go under the categorize like that means there's less chance for the underdeveloped country, right? Mm-hmm. To use a proper medication.
Mm-hmm. That is we need to categorize because of the problem of the resource. Just the resource, but in the future we would like to harmonization. We would like to have the equality in of the whole global globalization, that we would like to have everyone get the rehabilitation. Leave no one behind. Yeah, leave no one behind rehabilitation.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. Well, maybe you treated patients so well.
Okay,
so everybody is getting into old
thank
age
you.
Now.
Yeah.
So since we're moving into the aging society, so can you explain the common conditions in impacting walking ability of the older people? Did it seem to be just the body called just sickness? Mm-hmm. of the old age people walking, moving, right? Or any other?
Yeah. Okay. So when the people get older, one of the main problem is they will lose the strength. Okay, and they will get pain from degenerative joint disease. Mm-hmm. Okay, the loss of strength come from the weakness of the muscle, because the muscle get to be the sarcopenia is one condition that occur very rapidly in aging. Mm-hmm. Okay, and another one is like the insidious onset, but it's going day by day. Increase the severity day by day. It's called spinal stenosis. Mm. This is the main problem of the patient. Mm. Then osteoarthritis as well. Okay. For the spinal stenosis, the patient will have like the neck pain, back pain. Okay, that is quite common. And when the aging population get neck pain or back pain, commonly they will have they don't want to move, okay? Inability. Fear of falling, or maybe they have a lot of pain, and they don't want to move or don't want to walk, okay? Mm-hmm. And maybe get to the bedridden. That is another one problem. If the disease progressive to be the more severe day after day, more severe. Mm-hmm. Okay.
The doctor, but these are the symptoms, these are the sickness of the aging people. We all know about it. You know it advanced already. Is there any protection or anything it advanced that for them not to get into that?
Yes. Normally we, in the medical rehabilitation, we advise the patient to exercise.
Yes,
that is the fundamental treatment that we always prescribe the exercise. Mm. Get moving. Otherwise, the muscle will get weakness and you have more degenerative joint, more stiffness. Mm. But because of the aging process, the patient will have narrowing of the spine. Okay.
Narrow. Okay.
Yes.
The spine is run down.
Run
from
down.
Behind the neck.
From
down
the neck to the sacroiliac to the coccyx. Okay.
Yes.
Neck, thoracic, lumbar, and then sacral, and then coccyx.
Okay.
So, when the aging process occur, let's say that after 30 years old, and then progress after 50 years old. Okay, the spine, we've got the degenerative joint and narrowing of the canal. Okay, so in the spinal canal, they have like the spinal cord.
Okay.
Have the spinal nerve root. Have the vessel, blood vessel. Come out of the spinal canal. Okay. If the spinal canal get narrowing, the nerve and the blood vessel will got entrapment. Okay. If entrapped of the nerve, the patient will have like the weakness and numbness. Okay. Together with the entrap of the blood vessel, the patient will have more numbness. And difficult to walk as well. Can walk just for a while, just a short distance, and then the patient need to rest because of the calf pain or maybe back pain as well. Okay, the patient will have a severe back pain and calf pain and shortening of the walking distance. Okay, this is the problem, and then will refuse to walk and then go into the bedridden state.
This is a sad part of it, because life had been so troublesome with that, with the people around them, with themselves, not be able to move, right? But with the today medication, wouldn't it be better for them to be cured, to be treated, or giving proper medication?
For the medication also helpful as well during the first state when the patient have pain, they have inflammation from the degenerative joint. The painkiller or anti-inflammatory drug or muscle relaxant also helpful. Okay, together with the stretching exercise, strengthening exercise, very helpful as well. Okay, but when the disease progress, the medication, the exercise cannot, only that cannot help for the patient. Then the patient may get a physical therapy such as a lumbar traction, okay, or cervical traction for the cervical spine. But it's helpful only in the mild degree. If the patient more severe, in the past, the patient will we're going to do the surgical procedure.
All right, let's take a break and then we'll come back to the current advanced treatment. We are coming to the end of the first part of our interview, so please stay tuned for the next.
Have to deal with pollution, stress, and lots of junk food. This causes rapid growth of free radicals, which is the main reason that we become ill, without realizing it. Thai coloured rice can prevent that, because the premium Thai coloured rice is rich in essential vitamins and minerals, which work as antioxidants. A tasty way to stay healthy and not get sick. Enjoy bright skin and healthy excretory system. More importantly, it's low in sugar, so it doesn't make you fat. It's gluten-free, which is suitable for someone with wheat allergy, and edible for people of all ages and genders. All the benefits of coloured rice will make you beautiful from the inside out. Since good health means good life, we'd like you to prove it yourself. Colours of Thai rice, colours of your life. Think Thai rice, think Thailand.
Welcome back once again to our program. So let's continue our discussion about common health conditions among the older adults with Professor Dr. Arirat Suputhithada. Professor, doctor. we did lift a little bit on the treatment of the related to with the spinal stenosis. It's difficult for me to end this thing. But anyways, can you give us more details about that, please?
Okay, so if the patient fail conservative, let's say that fail medication, fail exercise, we also have a more advanced as a extracorporeal shockwave therapy. Yes, it's like the air pressure to release the pain, to release the pain by produce the some neurotransmitter and also increase the vascularization and get rid of the calcification. Okay, but in a lot of patients, if the the disease progress is not respond to extracorporeal shockwave. Now a day, I do advancement, very advanced of treatment in spinal stenosis. It is ultrasound guidance, spinal injection. Okay, so I use ultrasound for guidance for screening the spinal canal and the spinal column and to see the facet joint. Facet joint is the joint in the back, in the posterior column of the spine.
Okay,
scan to see the facet joint and to see the medial branch. Medial branch is the nerve supply to the facet joint. Okay, it comes from spinal nerve and also the muscle around the facet joint. Multifidus that are mostly have like the fibrosis or calcification in the spinal column in this area. Okay, so I use ultrasound to guide and then use a low dose xylocaine, low dose lidocaine. To inject.
How often to be injected?
Okay, so in the one treatment, okay, I use the technique that put only one needle insertion and only one insertion and inject these three points, okay, in the same time in the one spinal level. Do four spinal level in one treatment. Four spinal level. Yes, but the patient very comfortable.
Really? They don't feel pain or something?
No. Okay, and also I do like this for, let's say that 3 to 4 times, okay, once per week, okay.
Once a week.
Once a week. But in the worldwide, some physicians also use corticosteroid to inject. But on the literature, on the evidence base, we found that even the xylocaine injection also helpful, okay, because of the needling effect, needling because of the needle. I use the needle to clear off the calcification, okay, and fibrosis, okay, and use like the xylocaine to block the pain reception, use the xylocaine to block the pain reception. Okay, and because of the needle together with the xylocaine can cause a desensitization. Okay, can block the axonal transportation of the pain perception. So the patient will release of the pain and also the calcification, the fibrosis around the facet joint, around the nerve, around the muscle also wash out as well. Okay, within the 3 to 4 times. And then after that, the patient can move, can have a better movement. Because and the facet joint can have a gliding movement. Okay, and the muscle can be stretching because of release of the fibrosis and release of the calcification already.
Interesting. Okay. Well, this is something to be done. Can be done.
Yes, can be done in the outpatient clinic.
Okay, outpatient clinic.
And the patient can get improvement within a short period of time.
So what is your advice to the elderly to prevent the spinal stenosis conditions?
Okay, if the elderly have a only my symptom, my pain. I mean, and because before doing this posterior, need to do the MRI of the lower spine.
To see what's going on.
To see the spinal canal, to see the intervertebral disc, to see the facet joint, to see the severity of the spinal stenosis as well. Okay, and to rule out to differentiate the other problem, such as a tumor mass or the other disease of the spine as well. To rule out of that. Okay, and then if the patient have mild degree, use only drug and exercise. If moderate degree of a spinal stenosis, before going to do surgery, surgical intervention, the patient can choose this advancement. Mm. Okay, choose ultrasound Skydance spinal injection okay. instead of going to do the surgical directly. Mm. Okay, mm. If I do the, let's say that 3 to 4 times mm. and the patient get better. Mm. After that, we prescribe the exercise mm. for the patient. Mm. Okay. Mm. Prescribe the stretching, strengthening mm. exercise, and then after that, because the pain gone, mm. the pain mm. released already, mm. and the patient can move the spine better. Mm. Okay, so the patient can do exercise and avoid abnormal posture as well, such as avoid prolonged sitting, prolonged standing mm. more than 30 minutes. Mm. Okay, and avoid weightlifting. Lifting of the object that is very very dangerous for the spine in the elderly. Okay, this is the health education that I will give for the patient. Mm-hmm. Okay,
so such a great mm-hmm. advice that Professor Dr. Arilat is giving. But also, how about food? The initially consumption of food in a younger age or even the average before getting into old age, mm-hmm. is there any helpful or any nothing can be
okay.
done?
If talk about food, okay, for the younger, I would recommend to mm. avoid of the some condition that will damage the mm. the spine, such
advanced,
as the yes gouty arthritis. Uh-huh. So need to be careful mm. about the food that produce purine. That we have a gouty arthritis, okay? And also need to keep the bone healthy, okay? The bone need calcium supplement, so need to choose the food that have more calcium to get strength of the bone, okay? So that is in general, I think this is a concept that not destroy the bone, not destroy the joint by avoid purine food consumption, and increase the strength of the bone mineral by increase the calcium and vitamin D supplement as well. Yeah. Okay.
To mm-hmm. your experience, Professor, present days seem to be, I have seen less. I don't know because I'm not dealing with the medication thing, but we could see, we see elderly people walking in department store, shopping, and more than we see them on wheels. Yeah, so is that because of the better advancement in medication or what in our country?
Okay. Yes. Yeah. You mean the wheel mm. yes, in the basket, right? Mm. I think that is like the walker, the wheel walker. Yes, that the elderly would like to support themselves because they fear of falling. Mm. Okay, during movement, during pick up the food into the basket. Yeah. So I think it's a good recommendation. Yeah. Good, yeah. Because I always recommend the patient to use if they have difficulty in walking. Yes. Okay, if the treatment not complete yet. Okay, they will have difficulty in walking, so they need to have a support. Yeah. Yes, that kind of support is very very good as well. Very good idea. Yeah.
So what is your expectation of the future trends in rehabilitation medicine?
If talk about only the spinal stenosis,
yes.
Okay, I think that I would like that the patient, the elderly patient in Thailand mm-hmm. and in globally as well, internationally as mm-hmm. well, globally as well, to have the chance to treat. To get the treatment, okay. If they have only my degree, only medication, exercise, and basic rehabilitation, that is enough. Mm-hmm. Okay. If the disease progress or aging process, okay, they need more advancement. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Because if they continue to do the rehabilitation, the traditional one, mm-hmm. it will take time, and maybe they need the rehabilitation for the whole life. Mm. Okay, so if they can get a chance to do this advancement, okay, mm-hmm. they will get improvement within the short period of time, only 1 month or 1.5 months, mm-hmm. and then after that, they need to do exercise. Mm-hmm. Okay, do strengthening exercise, stretching exercise, mm-hmm. aerobic exercise, mm-hmm. and I would like to recommend the water exercise. Oh. Well, yes, they're really good for the elderly. Okay, and but unfortunately, if the patient get come to see the doctor in the late state already, mm. maybe they need to do surgery. Yeah. So it's depend. Mm. Okay, it's depend on the state that the patient come. So, my expectation in the future, yeah. I would like the healthcare system to include the rehabilitation, not yes. only morbidity, not only mortality measurement, mm. but quality of life measurement as well. Okay, that will make yeah. the elderly patient can get a chance better to do life. The rehabilitation, to do all of the advancement as well.
All right, thank you so much, ma'am, for being here, and please do come back and tell us more if you have any case or anything that you talk about this. Any other program with great thanks to Professor Dr. Arirat Suputitada. He's from the Department of Rehabilitation Medicine, Faculty of Medicine, Chulalongkorn University. Very appreciate for your participation today. So I really hope you enjoy the show and have a great day. Thanks for watching Thailand Today. But don't forget that you can watch Thailand Today on NBT World channel or live broadcast on YouTube channel NBT World every Tuesday to Friday from 9 p.m. onwards. So see you next time. Then we'll think about 70.